Hello everyone and welcome to part 7 or 8 of the Skyrim Special Edition playthrough with the Orc Mage. I've decided we're going to postpone the Mage's, the College of Winterhold quests and go and do the Way of the Voice with Lydia. So we're going to travel to Iverstead. Because we've been to Windhelm, we're going to actually travel to Windhelm Stables and make our way to Riften from there. Hopefully we'll be able to get to Iverstead in this episode, we'll see. But definitely by the next episode we should be able to get there. Alright. Let's see where we are. Obviously we're at the College of Winterhold, so we're going to travel Windhelm. There's actually a quicker way. You can go down here, up that way, so that's what we'll do. Travel to Windhelm and do that. We'll fight a dragon in between there, because there's a dragon lair right in the middle of this marshland, or hot spring land, or whatever you want to call it. So we'll kill a dragon and then make our way to Iverstead, doing the shortcut way instead of the long way. It'll save us about half an hour of time. Okay, so let's put a marker down there because that's where the dragon lair is. So let's just take that off. We've got Lydia with us, so she'll help. Direct some of the fire, as in enemy fire. Oh, I should have bought some more conjuration spells, but did not. The next perk we're going to do is summoner. This is a stupid perk, but you have to get it to get these, the better perks. So. And then do augmented flames and don't know about frost, because there's really no enemies in Skyrim other than flame atronachs and fire breathing dragons that are vulnerable to frost, so that will be a least of our priorities. Alright, no, we don't need that. Okay. Traveling on foot isn't as bad as it sounds. It's actually quite fun. See things that you usually wouldn't see before, would see obviously while fast traveling. But it can save you a few deaths, just in case, you know, if you're traveling the snowy wilderness and you come up into you meet a frost troll and you're low level, it will most probably kill you. Unless you have a follower. Followers seem to help direct some of the fire. You can hear the dragon if I be quiet for a second. Yep, you can hear it. Alright. There's a little witch's hut here which we will deal with first. Alright. Definitely need more magicka. A pain in the ass. Alright, killed her, easy. Alright, healing. Just take her robes because they're worth quite a bit. Hargraven feathers, this is a good supply of Hargraven feathers if you're into alchemy at all. And there's a skill book under here, which we've already read. So, doesn't benefit us, we'll just sell that when we need the cash. Right, the dragon is up here. Let's move the marker. It's up here. Oh, for God's sake. Fuck that up. Right. Dragon should be around here somewhere. You can obviously hear it. There it is. Alright, let's flame match knock. Bound sword. And he's gonna go fight some mammoth. Frost dragon. Firebolt. Just wait a bit for our magic to recharge. I don't know what the dragons. Yeah, he's gonna fight some giants. Oh, don't tell me that. Oh, fucking hell, the giant became hostile. I didn't even hit the giant. Alright, let's, we do have Berserker Rage. Alright, I'll activate that. That'll be good. I hate giants. Sorry, Lydia. Where's that dragon? Where's the body? Oh, over here. We'll take the dragon bones and the dragon scales so we can sell them. Probably when we get to civilization next. Luckily the mammoths didn't go hostile, because they would have destroyed us. Bone string crest, if I remember correctly, this is frost breath. We'll check the chest first. Wear them. Actually, pretty good, pretty good chest, that was. I'm actually gonna unlock that. Pretty good shout, actually, Frostbreath. I've got a bad feeling about this. Yeah, but we've already killed all the dragons, Lydia. What are you talking about? Now, this standing stone we're actually going to get. It's the Atronarch Stone. Very, very helpful if you're a mage. I think it's 50% spell absorption, which will help us. The only downside is the fact that if we use like summoned creatures like Flame Atronachs, the spell will fail, but we gain the magicka from it, plus a little bit more, which I'll explain in a minute after we get the stone. I love the way how they've decorated each stone. Nicely. Lots of plants and stuff. Alright. I will demonstrate the, oh, we do have, alright. See? The summon didn't, summon. because of the astronaut stone, so it might take a few summons. What the f- I hate wolves.
Take this and hold on to it. I'll be back for it later. I'll pay you good. Don't lose it.
Slow down, explain yourself.
No time to talk. Snitch or double cross me and I'll kill you. I mean it.
Did you see someone run past just now? Yes. How did you get this? Never mind. Here. It's not much, but it's something. I'm going to track down that thief. Murder him.
I killed him for you. Take your gold. Alright. Let's have a look where we are. Yeah. Should be able to actually get up the High Hrothgar in this episode if we're quick. I do hear a dragon. Oh, yep, here we go. Two dragons in one episode. See how it's failing? It's annoying, but we'll deal with it. I don't know what type of dragon this is, but shock damage seems to work just as well. I want to know what type of dragon this is. He's not attacking. Oh shit. Okay, I'm gonna level up so we can get more health. This one is what we want. What I hate about dragons, if they see another enemy, they'll go towards that. No one knows it's a fire dragon. I spike. Okay, the dragons. Disappearing. I don't know where it's going. It's going to a dragon lair. There's no point in going to get it. Well, there is actually. We get a dragon soul, but it's going to take forever to get up there. We could go up this way. Ah, oh, fuck it, we'll just go to Alvestad. Try to go down without killing ourselves. Oh, what the hell? I swear to God, the dragon is just... We want ice spike. Flame etch note. Even though it won't do much. Where the hell is it? Oh, what the hell? Alright, potions. That was a very... That was a glitched dragon, I swear. Alright, we'll still get this all. Alright, now on to Ivarstead. Hopefully we don't run into another dragon. Okay, we got another soul. I don't know if we should spend on ice form or not. I don't really want to. I want to save the soul just in case we need it. For another time. Okay. We're now in the rift. So Ivarstead is just a short walk.
Business. Be on your way.
Oh, motherfucker. I bet she was gonna come for me. Well, my aim sucks. Take his gold. Well, that was interesting. I hate saber cats, especially at low levels. They will absolutely destroy you if you're not careful. It's a bear. I don't think we'll mess with it. Oh well. We're just gonna go climb High Hrothgar.
Never settle down to have children. I know your sights are set beyond this town, but for now.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something.
Alright. I went the wrong way.
On your way up the 7,000 steps again, Clement?
Not today.
See, in less than 20 minutes we made it from Windhelm to here, so fast traveling doesn't really take hold of a lot of time. I'm gonna wait about an hour. Yeah. So Lydia comes, because there's a frost troll up here, which we might have a bit of difficulty. Sorry about, if you really wanted to watch more Mages Guild quests, then more than happy to go back into Winterhold and do that, but, I really want to, do the main quest, to get it over and done with, which might may be of your interest or not, just gotta let me know if it is or not. The only real reason I like doing the main quest is to get the Dragon Wren shout. That shout is a godsend when fighting dragons. Ice Wraith. Seem to be stuck on armor. I'm gonna get healing. Yes, we... Oh, but his body went down. That's alright. See, being a mage, you don't really need to worry about your health. Because you can dish out heaps and heaps of damage before they even get to you, and you've got all other tools of which you can use instead of having to use a sword and a shield or a bow and an arrow. You've got the illusion spells, which are extremely strong. Their effects, when you're like a high level with illusion, you can even affect undead and Daedra and automatons in the dwarven ruins, which is extremely helpful. You don't even have to fight a single enemy going through one of those places, and you don't need stamina either. Now, I know there's a frost. Wolves are the least of our worries. I'm gonna actually summon the Flame Archonarch. If you didn't already know, trolls are very weak to fire. And there's Lydia, who just teleported. There it is. Okay, that was easier than I thought it would be. Oh, And that is the last enemy of this episode. I'm pretty sure, unless we run into another guy up here. I'm going to learn the two shouts and the Greybeards, and then the next episode we will continue with going to what's it called? Ustengrav. To get the Horn of Jürgen Windcaller. I love climbing High Hrothgar. There's so much to see, and they call it 7,000 steps, but some guy actually counted the number of steps, but it's not even 4,000, I don't think. It's probably much less than that. But that doesn't really matter. And we are here. Q disease, we might want that.
Appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
You call me Dragonborn, what does that mean?
First, let us see if you truly are Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice. I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here?
I want to find out what it means to be Dragonborn.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit. Just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you.
You mean I'm not the only Dragonborn?
You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only Dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say.
I'm ready to learn.
You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing.
I've got your back. As you wish, my thane.
When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Ro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thum more sharply.
Ro!
As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly.
Okay.
High above, voice within. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Rome.
I'm just doing this part of the, because it's boring, you might as well get it over and done with.
Now, let's see how quickly you can master the new. Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear. Well done. Again. You learn quickly. Once more.
Easy.
Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Borley.
Now this next shell is pretty useful when traveling. We don't have to wait for them or follow them, we just wait them there for them down here.
Master Bori will teach you Wulp, which means whirlwind. You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thumb. Approach Master Bori and he will give you.
Better equip it before I forget.
Master Wolfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bori.
X!
Wolf!
Okay.
Now it's your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes. Your quick mastery of a new thum is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself.
Thank you. What's next?
You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengraf. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return. Dragons have always been able to shout. Language is intrinsic to their very being. There is no difference in the dragon tongue between debating and fighting. Shouting comes as naturally to a dragon as breathing or speaking. In mythic times, when mortal kind was in great need, the goddess Kinnereth granted us the ability to speak as dragons do. For most people, long years of training are required to learn even the simplest shout. But for you, the dragon speech is in your blood. and you learn it almost without effort. Breath and focus.
Alright. We're just going to, we are going to, travel to Holder's Stream Camp, and then we're going to end the episode. I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry about, the last 10 minutes being slightly boring, but it had to be done. Stay tuned for more. I will be back soon. Peace.